Hello, and welcome back to Bitwig, featuring the grid. So if I go ahead and grab our basic polygrid patch here, I get sound right out of the box. So as I play notes, they're being articulated. The triangle wave oscillator is being shaped by an amplifier, which is under the control of an attack release envelope. So I've got segment controls here. If we want to slow down either side of it or change their shapes. Now, part of the nice reason that the envelopes are working and there's not so many chords everywhere is this little pre-chord here, which, playing notes, no sound, is connecting the gate of the device input, so any note received is now automatically triggering the AR by default. So that's nice. What we're going to look at now are the two basic kinds of modulation signals. So one would be an envelope. In this case, I will pull in an AD envelope instead, an attack decay, which is not sensitive to how long I hold it down. It just has a quick attack stage and then a release stage of whatever time we ask it for. But if I hold the note down longer, it doesn't matter. It's still going to end. You'd often use this in percussion sounds or for plenty of other reasons. The other option would be something like an LFO, a periodic waveform. So the LFO being periodic means its output is repeating over and over and over again without me having to ask for that output. So if I were to plug in an oscilloscope real quick, we can see that the LFO is going all the time. We'll put them in yellow. And then our AD is only going when note inputs trigger him to go. He is aperiodic, not regular. So these are our two basic kinds of modulation signals that we're looking at today. Now let's try wiring them into our patch. Now the easiest way to hear a control signal is to wire it into pitch, because that's what our ear is most sensitive to. So I'm going to go ahead and take the output of this AD envelope and put it to the pitch input, hence the orange port and the label down below, of the triangle wave. Now, at first, I hear no change, because input ports that have a knob next to them have an attenuator. This knob is representing an amplifier that's saying how much of the incoming modulation signal should affect the bus it's connected to. So by default, they tend to be at zero. No signals coming in, it has no effect on the sound. Now if I were to increase this, since it's pitch, the ST is telling me I'm doing this in semitones. So almost to a dub siren already. So if I were to control click this, we could just skip up and say I want it to be an octave, 12 semitones, which is a nice even interval, except why don't we hear the octave? Well, the amplitude envelope on the AR here is going slowly, and the pitch envelope on the AD is attacking very, very quickly. So it's reaching the octave before we even hear it. If I were to slow down the attack stage of the AD envelope, now we hear the full octave range. But in this case, the effect I was looking for was just kind of chipping the sound. Now, one thing about setting up modulation signals, it's a good practice if you're going to use the keyboard for trigger, because we're playing different notes, is to make sure that the apparent pitch is the same when the attenuator is open as when it's closed. So what am I actually saying here? With the attenuator fully closed, we're just hearing the notes played on the keyboard. And as long as the apparent pitch, the way our ear hears the pitch, does not change, then we will still be hearing the notes played on the keyboard. We could set this up in a funny way where the note on the keyboard is no longer the center pitch, but then it's hard to make music because the notes you're playing don't correspond to what you're hearing. So that's one aperiodic example using the AD. What if we were to use the LFO and maybe let's switch it to a pulse wave. So you can see already before we even hear it, it's going from zero to its maximum value. And again, in this case, our maximum value is whatever the attenuator is set to. So if I wire this instead of from the envelope to the LFO, we should now hear a musical trill. Going from one pitch to another. And again, our little attenuator test I just mentioned, when we zero this out, we hear a key, and now as we open it, we hear the exact relative of that key. Perfect. So now when we play notes on the keyboard and sequence notes into our session, everything's still going to be working fine. Hooray. Now, a different kind of use for an LFO controlling pitch would be vibrato in a musical sense, to slightly vibrate the pitch. So if I go to a more regular shape for vibrato, going a little bit back and forth, now when I play notes, I get not vibrato. That sounds more like a glissando over and over again. Why is that? Well, if we think about it in words, vibrato is usually a small change in pitch. So going by an octave is probably not helping us. Let's try a small change in pitch. And its speed is usually, let's say, around 6 times per second, give or take. So that sounds like vibrato. We've got it wired in. We've got it working. The only issue is I can hear already we are starting to violate our attenuator test. If I were to open this further, it doesn't sound like the pitch I'm playing anymore. Now the reason is, where the trill made sense to go from zero to maximum, vibrato normally vibrates around the pitch that you are playing. So that would mean we need this to operate in a bipolar fashion. So I can click our little bipolar icon on the LFO, and suddenly, instead of going from zero to maximum, it's going from minimum value, negative one in signal terms, to maximum. So now, we probably need to open the attenuator a little less this time. And now we've got a vibrato that is centered around the pitch that we're playing. Now, if we want to make things a little bit more complicated, and sometimes that means interesting, let's make the vibrato fade in instead of happening immediately. We've kind of got the two waves that we need already. One envelope that only triggers on the key and opens as we play, and then the regular LFO creating the vibrato. So if I were to run the vibrato through the amplifier that's built in to the envelope generator, just as we saw here, where our sound is having its amplitude controlled. Now we take the output of the amplifier and we'll put it into the pitch input. And again, we're not hearing what we were hoping for immediately. Let's look at this on the scope real quick. Let's take the same output. Remember, we are using an AD envelope, which has no interest in sustain. It's just going up quickly and down over the fixed time. So if this was longer, we'd hear the vibrato a little bit, but it's still wrong. This isn't the envelope we want. So if I go back to our envelope category, maybe in AR, just like was in our patch already, for amplitude, and now we should have sustain. There we go. So I'm going to slow down the fade in time, maybe a little more, and maybe even give it a little bit of a curve so it seems like it's taking longer. we go. So that's our look at some basic modulation sources. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you again soon.